Hello, and welcome to Good News That Actually Is, where 3 to 5 sets you free to thrive. 3 to 5 minute encouragements to help your joy by empowering your soul. I am your host, Tim Atchley. Well, hello, friends, to this Friend Friday, and I have with me a special guest from Colombia, a friend I met some years ago. His name is George, and George has an amazing story to his life, and I think you're going to really enjoy today's interview with him. So, of course, you can call him Jorge, or you can call him George. I call him George because I'm an American, and that's how we say things. But anyway, George, if you just take a minute to tell us a little bit about yourself and what you're doing and where you're doing it.
Well, yes. I was just this past week, I was just remembering the experience that we had about 2 or 3 years ago. I think more than that. About 3 years ago when we were in Apartado in Colombia.
We were.
My God, that was a beautiful time that we spent together. And well, yes, that's about my life. Well, I can only say that I'm here because of the grace of God. I'm a pastor, also an evangelist, you know, with my wife and my kids. I've been married for the last 26 years with Leslie. And together we have a beautiful family.
Yes.
Sammy, Isabella, and David. We all worked here in Colombia. I came to Colombia. You know, I was born in Colombia, but when I was just a baby, about a year old, my dad and my mom, they moved up to the United States and Guatemala because of my dad's profession. And I grew up in the States part of my life, about 23 years of my life. I grew up in New York. And then as you know, time went by, I got involved with the wrong people, with the wrong crowd, and I ended up visiting wrong places. And unfortunately for me, I ended up in jail, but that was the best thing that could happen to me. just to make a long story short, I was sentenced to so many years in prison, and there I met with the Lord, and God saved me in Florida. This happened about 33 years already, this April. The 13th, it'll be my 33rd year of, walking with the Lord. And I'm so grateful because my life never been the same ever since I met the Lord. And so what can I tell you about what I do today? I came back to Colombia in 94. God brought me here. I didn't want to come here, but God managed things that I was sent back to Colombia. And ever since I came here, God has been accomplishing and achieving all his promises to my life. I met my beautiful wife, Leslie, here. We married in 95. And ever since, I've been just doing God's work as an interpreter, traveling around. That's how I met with our friend, Steve Fado. How we met. I met Steve in 96, I think, 95, 96. And we travel all over Latin America and doing the evangelism, and discipling people. And it's been just so amazing. Got involved in church planting.
Yeah.
And we've been planting churches in Colombia, all over the Caribbean region, here in the coffee area in Medellin. We just planted our last congregation almost 3 years ago.
Wow.
I love discipling. I love raising up, disciples and training leaders for the church. Just teaming up, with people like you. And I enjoy very much reading your writings and learning from you. You're a great teacher. And many things that I've learned from you, I have applied here. And my goodness, they work. I mean, they're so good. That's basically, what we do. We've been doing for the last 20 some years. And ever since 5 years ago, God gave us our dream of opening up a children's dining hall, because with going through a steady war here in Colombia between the guerrillas, the government, the paramilitary thing. And my wife always dreamed about having this dining hall for the children of the war. And we feed about 120 some children every week. Wow. And their moms. They come from the Pacific area and also from the jungles. And God has been great. I mean, his grace, and he loves these children. He's always provided our, you know, people, friends that contribute. And so we now are praying, because now we grew up so much with these kids. Now we need a new venue, and we are praying for, you know, this lot that we found. And so we are really trusting God that because we know he's faithful.
Yeah.
And he's provided up until now. We are now praying for some resources so we can buy this piece of land, so we can build up what we call the community center for the children.
Right.
And our dream is, you know, not just to feed them with physical food, but we've been doing also with the Bible. We have our a Bible training for youngsters, because we started this work really evangelizing that area about 11 years ago. But just until about 5 years ago, we were able to build we started at a shack, you know, wooden shack. And now we've been growing up, and now is the time to, we are praying to buy this land so we go, can build our community center. And so we will have like, you know, like a training hall and a conference room, so we can also have church there for the kids. My wife wants to open up like a musical training school for kids. So it's, we're busy. I mean, you know, I work every day as a medical interpreter, as I told you before. So I can, you know, we've been supporting the church and also having the dining hall. So we're full. We had our hands full. And, you know, that's how I learned from you guys. Be busy for the Lord.
Stay busy. You can't get bored, and you can't get depressed if you keep your hands active in what he gives you, right?
Amen. Yes.
So, George, would you take just a minute and just encourage our viewers and listeners with a word, whatever's in your heart to share briefly with them to encourage them? That would be fantastic. I know they'd love to hear that.
Of course. You see, my favorite portion of the Bible, and that has helped me and my wife and our family together, is located in Hebrews, verses 1 and 2. You know, we walk every day keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus. He is the author and the finisher of our holy faith. And I can tell you something. I was just ministering to a youngster this week. And I told him, I said, you need to trust Jesus and keep focus on him, because he always does wonders, you know, where people now, even with the pandemic situation, they kind of gave up on their dreams. We've noticed that keeping our eyes fixed on Jesus, he is in charge of bringing up things, you know, that no one can give you. So my best counsel and advice to everyone that is listening and watching this beautiful program of yours, Tim, is keep your eyes fixed on Jesus.
Yes.
Just keep on him, and do not let anything, you know, steal your dreams with Jesus. If you trust him, you look at him, he'll do wonders. And if he can do things with an ex-convict like me, imagine what he can do with people so beautiful like you.
Hey, he's no respecter of persons. Aren't you glad?
Oh, no. Yes. I'm so glad.
Which I did a full interview with you about your testimony when we were in Apatardo. Yeah. And man, how he moved. You remember the chef there in the hotel that came to meet Jesus while we were there? Raphael? Yeah. And Raphael's still in contact. We're still in contact with each other.
Oh, my God.
And, yeah. And so I send him stuff, and he does it. And he's training up chefs. He's got a school. And he's in Colombia.
Oh my God!
So he moved to a different area of Colombia than Apatardo. I think he moved to Bogota. I'll have to double check that, but I think it's Bogota. Sure. And so, it's possible I may be in Bogota and Cartagena in August.
Oh, let me know. So
I'll let you know. So you know our friend Javier, he's always putting stuff together. So they're working on the next thing. So but it'll be good. And it's always good to hear from you. Now, everybody hearing your story and listening to what you're doing there and everything else, if there's somebody wanting to find out more about you or look you up online, where would they go?
Okay, they can find me. I have a Facebook, a profile. Uh-huh. It's Jorge Alberto Arango at Facebook.
So that's J-O-R-G-E?
Yes, J-O-R-G-E. Albert with the O at the end, Alberto Arango, A-R-A-N-G-O. So they will find me there. And they also can find us at New Breed Christian Church in Colombia. That's the name of our church in English, New Breed. Okay.
New Breed Christian Church.
Yeah. Yes.
And that's in Medellin.
That's in Medellin, yes.
Yeah, which I've been there with you. Medellin blew my mind the way they build those high rises on the sides of the mountains and stuff. Incredible. And we had an amazing time in Medellin. And if you remember in the last meeting, the storm came.
Yes.
And we left to go back to the airport where we were flying out of, and we came in. We were stopped by a landslide. We had to drive through a landslide to get back to the airport.
Where have we been going through things?
Never a dull moment, you know.
Yeah.
Oh God. So, but it's great to see you, and say hi to your wife for me. And got to meet her when we got back to Medellin, you know, and so that's great. And so glad your family's doing well. And I'm really thankful you could take this time today and be with us and share with people. I know they'll be interested and be blessed to hear your story and to hear your encouragement. And so thank you for the time, George, and look forward to seeing you again in the near future.
Okay. I just like to give you the dining hall, the children's dining hall.
Yeah.
Instagram. It's okay. El Comedor de Emanuel. I don't know if you want, I can spell it to you.
Yes.
E-L-C-O-M as Mary, E as Elephant, D as David, O-R, El Comedor, D-D-E, Emanuel. Just like that, Emanuel. That's the name.
El Comedor Emanuel.
Yeah, the Comedor de Emanuel. And they can look at what we're doing there with the kids and the families. It's in Instagram.
All right, it's on Instagram. Excellent. Yeah. You'll send me those links, and then in the video of the podcast, they'll be able to see that on a slide. So great to be with you, George. I know you got to get back to your interpretive business there. But thanks for spending time, man.
Oh, no, it's been a pleasure. It's my privilege. Man, I admire you so much, and I love the Lord because I met you, and you taught me many things that they got stuck in my heart. You know, you're a great Bible teacher. I always enjoy listening to you.
Well, thank you.
Your writing.
Thank you. And you're an encouragement to be with. And that's the way it is in the Lord, isn't it? So,
amen. Yes.
Well, be blessed, brother. And say hi to your wife for me. God bless you.
All right. Thank you. God bless.
Thanks for tuning in today. Never forget that you are loved by a faithful God whose obedient Son, Jesus Christ, willingly died on a cross so that you can live today and always from the abundance of His life in you. Please subscribe and share this with others so that they too can experience the 3 to 5 that sets you free to thrive. And be sure to tune in next time to Good News That Actually Is. Please visit us at our website, goodnewsthatactuallyis.com. There you'll find transcripts of the program, video files, and other opportunities. We look forward to visiting with you there and ask you to subscribe. Have a great day.